So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session guys, as usually I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. And guys, in today's session we are going to discuss 5 questions and all the 5 questions are very very important. 3 questions are related to the extension of 3 government schemes and a question loan ka hai aur uske alawa ek question hai वेज रेट इंडेक्स का न्यू सीरीज आ गया है. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन गाइस. बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, इफ यू आर कमिंग हियर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, डू सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन. यू कैन ऑल्सो जॉइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप. हियर यू विल गेट द पीडीएफ ऑफ दिस सेशन आफ्टर द सेशन इज कंप्लीटेड. एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो फॉलो मी ऑन इंस्टाग्राम. हियर ऑल्सो यू कैन आस्क एनी डाउट. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन विच इज रिगार्डिंग अक्रॉस स्कीम. So you have to consider the following statements with respect to the ACROSS scheme and you have to identify the correct statement. So we are discussing ACROSS scheme because the scheme, the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved the continuation of this particular scheme which is known as ACROSS. And of course there is a full form of ACROSS which is Atmosphere and Climate Research Modeling Observing Systems and Services. This is the full form of ACROSS. There is no need to remember the full form, koi zarurat nahi hai. And along with ACROSS, its eight sub schemes have also been continued. Now remember, the scheme has been continued starting from the year 2021 to the 2026, and the total estimated cost for this extension is rupees 2135 crores. Now talking about the scheme, so remember the scheme is being implemented by Ministry of Earth Sciences, which is headed by Dr. Jitendra Singh, and it pertains to the atmospheric science programs of Ministry of Earth Science, and it addresses different aspects of weather and climate services. Weather or climate services se related jitne bhi different aspects hai, ye usko cater karta hai. Now there are 4 implementing agencies for this particular scheme, which is IMD, and then we have National Center for Medium Range Weather Forecasting, then we have Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology, and finally INCOIS, which is Indian National Center for Ocean Information Services. And there are 8 sub schemes, as I told you. These are the 8 sub schemes. Now of course you don't have to go into the details of these 8 sub schemes, bas ek bar padh lo aur apne dimag mein rakhna ki kaun kaun si 8 sub schemes hain. Commissioning of polarimetric Doppler weather radars, upgradation of forecast system, weather and climate services, atmospheric observations network, numerical modeling of weather and climate, monsoon mission, monsoon convection, clouds and climate change, and high performance computing system. So basically guys, ACROSS scheme jo hai, it is nothing but the combination of all the schemes which are being implemented by the Ministry of Earth Sciences. Basically unhone kya kiya, jitni bhi schemes thi Ministry of Earth Sciences ki, jitne bhi programs the, initiatives the chote chote, unko sabko mila ke ek umbrella scheme ke andar rakh diya. Theek hai, all the programs and initiatives of Ministry of Earth Sciences are put under one umbrella scheme, and that umbrella scheme is known as what? ACROSS. And now it has been continued till the year 2026. So this was about this news guys, and now let's come back to the question. The scheme has been continued till 2026, absolutely correct. Total estimated cost is rupees 3135 crore. Is that so? No, that's 2135 crores, okay. And there are 10 sub schemes under ACROSS. No, that's nahi hai. There are 8 sub schemes under ACROSS. So only one statement is correct, which means option C will be the correct answer. Okay. So I hope guys this question is clear. Moving ahead to another question which is based on another scheme. Consider the following statement with respect to O Smart scheme, and you have to identify the incorrect statement now. So again, it is in news because Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved the continuation of this scheme also, which is O Smart. And of course, OSMART has also the full form, Ocean Services Modeling Application Resources and Technology. Remember, this scheme has also been continued from the period 2021 to 2026. Yahan pe typo error hai, 2016 nahi hai, 26 hai. And the total estimated cost is rupees 2177 crore for the extension of this OSMART. Now talking about the scheme, so remember the scheme was launched in the year 2018 by Ministry of Earth Sciences to provide forecasting services based on the continuous observations of our oceans and development of technologies. Then second objective is to conduct the exploratory surveys for sustainable harnessing of our oceanic resources, both living and non-living. Okay, so basically in simple words, iska jo objective hai wo hai हमारे ओशंस को ऑब्जर्व करके उसके जो वेदर एंड वेदर से रिलेटेड फोरकास्ट बताना, सर्विसेज बताना, एंड देन ओशन में रिलेटेड जितने भी हमारे रिसोर्सेज है, आइदर वेदर इट इज लिविंग और नॉन लिविंग, उनसे रिलेटेड सर्वेस करना. राइट, नाउ देर आर सब दीज आर द सेवन इम्प्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसीज, सॉरी फाइव इम्प्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसीज ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर स्कीम, विच इज NIOT चेन्नई, इनकॉइस हैदराबाद, नेशनल सेंटर फॉर पोलर एंड ओशन रिसर्च, सेंटर फॉर मरीन लिविंग रिसोर्स एंड इकोलॉजी, एंड देन फाइनली वी हैव नेशनल सेंटर फॉर कोस्टल रिसर्च विच इज अगेन इन चेन्नई. एंड देर आर सेवन सब स्कीम्स अंडर दिस पर्टिकुलर मिशन: ओशन टेक्नोलॉजी, ओशन मॉडलिंग एंड एडवाइजरी सर्विसेज, ओशन ऑब्जर्वेशन नेटवर्क, ओशन नॉन लिविंग रिसोर्सेज, मरीन लिविंग रिसोर्सेज एंड इकोलॉजी, कोस्टल रिसर्च एंड ऑपरेशन एंड मेंटेनेंस ऑफ रिसर्च वेसल्स. सो अगेन यू डो नॉट हैव टू गो इन टू द डिटेल्स ऑफ दीज सेवन सब स्कीम्स, जस्ट रिमेंबर द नेम्स ऑफ दीज सेवन सब स्कीम्स. ओके, सो नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. द स्कीम वॉज लॉन्च इन 2016. नो, इट वॉज लॉन्च इन 2018. इट हैज बीन एक्सटेंडेड अप टू 2030. इज दैट सो? नो, 2026. And there are 8 sub-schemes under the scheme. No, again, it is also incorrect. There are 7 sub-schemes, which means all the statements are incorrect here. Option E, all are incorrect, will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 3. Consider the following statements with respect to the National Apprenticeship Training Scheme and you have to identify the correct statement. Again, this is in news because the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has extended this particular scheme also. Remember, the scheme was launched in the year 2016 by Ministry of Education, which is currently headed by Dr. Dharmendra Pradhan. And the objective of this scheme is to provide training to the apprentices who have completed graduation, either graduation or diploma in various streams. Okay. Now, talking about the extension, so remember, the scheme has been extended from this financial year to the financial year 2026, that is up to 31st March 2026. Total stipendary support that will be provided by the government is 3,054 crores. The graduates will be given a stipend of rupees 9,000, while the diploma holders will be given the stipend of rupees 8,000. And the target is to provide employment to about 7 lakh youths in the coming 5 years. So this was about this news. The scheme was launched in 2015. No, it was launched in 2016. The scheme has been extended from this financial year to this financial year. This is correct. And the implementing ministry is the Ministry of Education. And please do not get confused with the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. The implementing ministry for this particular scheme, for this particular mission, is the Ministry of Education. So 2 and 3 are correct. Option B will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 4, which is based on a question on loan. For how many states the Government of India has signed a loan agreement with Asian Development Bank, headquartered in Manila, worth $300 million to strengthen and improve access to comprehensive primary health care. Very, very important question, because ye loan kisi ek state ke liye nahi hai. This loan has been taken for 13 states. This loan has been taken for 13 states and these are the 13 states. Naam yaad rakhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai. Just remember the amount of the loan, the bank from which the loan is taken, and the number of state for which this loan is taken, and of course the purpose of the loan, that is to strengthen and improve access to comprehensive primary health care. So option B, guys, 13 is the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 5, which is the last question for today. You have to consider the following statements with respect to the new series of wage rate index, and again you have to identify the correct statements. So let's talk about the new series of wage rate index. So we are calling it new series because now the base year is changed, which is 2016 equals to 100, and it will replace the old base year, that was 1963-65 equals to 100. Remember, this wage rate index has been compiled by Labor Bureau and it will also be maintained by Labor Bureau only. And this new series would be compiled twice a year on half yearly basis. One is on as on 1st January and another as on 1st of July. Now talking about this new series, so remember, now there are total 37 industries in the new wage rate index basket against 21 in the earlier series. And out of these 37, 30 are from manufacturing sector, 4 are from mining, and 3 are from plantation sector. In this new basket, the current wage data has been collected from 2881 units under 37 selected industries. And about 700 occupations have been covered under these selected industries, and In the second half of the year 2020, the All India Wage Rate Index number is 119.7. Very, very important. भाई बहुत ज्यादा important है, याद रखना. All India Wage Rate Index number for the second half of 2020 is 119.7. And if we talk about the sector level, so highest wage index in the second half of 2020 was in the plantation sector, that is 126.5, followed by manufacturing sector and mining sector. Okay. So now let's come to the question. New base year of WRI is 2016 equals to 100. Yes, it has replaced 1963-65 as the base year. A total of 47 industries have been covered in the new WRI basket. No, that's not 47, it's 37. And in the second half of 2020, All India Wage Rate Index number stood at 119.7. So this is also correct. First and third are absolutely correct. Option C will be the correct answer. And guys, please do not confuse between these two numbers, 119.7 and 119.6. 119.7 is the All India Wage Rate Index number, while 119.6 is the manufacturing sector ka index number. Okay, so please do not get confused. And that's it for the session today. And guys, let me tell you ki ASER ki jo report hai wo aa gayi hai, aap sabko pata hi hoga of course. And now we have also NFHS 5 ka second phase, so both of these reports will be covered by me. But yes, since report jo hai bahut lambi hai, bahut badi badi hai, so it will definitely take some time. But don't worry, I will come up with a session comprehensively on these two reports only. ASER का अलग session होगा and NFHS 5 का अलग session होगा. So please wait. और अभी कोई वैसे exam भी नहीं है urgently. So अभी हम थोड़ा सा wait कर सकते हैं, because I don't want कि कोई भी data उसमें गलत जाए या कोई भी चीज छूटे. Okay. And that's it for the session. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.